In this problem, we'll take a look at cost of goods manufactured and cost of goods sold schedules. These are prepared before the income statement is prepared for a manufacturer. Saratella Manufacturing Corporation uses a job order costing system. Saratella's records show the following inventories. So we're given that beginning direct materials were $20,000 and ending $26,000. Work in process to begin with was $38,000. And at the end of the year, the balance is unknown. Finished goods, $80,000 at the beginning of the year and $73,000 at the end of the year. Due to a flood, records showing the value of the work in process inventory at the end of the period are missing. The following information relates to Saratella's operations for the year. Direct materials purchased, $120,000. Direct labor cost incurred, $78,000. Selling, general, and administrative expense incurred, $25,000. Manufacturing overhead cost incurred, $296,000. Manufacturing overhead applied, $285,000. And cost of goods manufactured, $502,000. What is the balance in Saratella's work in process inventory account at the end of the year? Well, with the information that we're given, the easiest way to do this is, or to find this number, is to prepare the cost of goods manufactured. First, we'll need to compute the direct material used. So we'll take beginning direct material inventory, which was $20,000 at the beginning of the year. We will add direct material purchases. Direct material purchased is given to be $120,000. This will give us direct material available for production of $140,000, less ending direct material inventory, which is given to be $26,000, and we'll get direct material used in production, $114,000. Now we can prepare the cost of goods manufactured. The direct material used is actually part of this schedule. Beginning work in process inventory, add current production cost, and that includes direct material used, direct labor, and overhead applied. Be sure to put overhead applied and not actual overhead costs here. We'll subtract our ending work in process inventory and we'll get cost of goods manufactured. So this is our basic cost of goods manufactured schedule. The direct material used was previously calculated to be $114,000. The beginning work in process inventory is $38,000, and ending work in process inventory is what we're trying to calculate. It is unknown due to the flood. The direct labor cost incurred was given to be $78,000, the overhead applied $285,000, and cost of goods manufactured was given to be $502,000. So we have all of the numbers in our schedule, and we will be able to then solve for the ending work in process inventory. We'll work backward, and so what that means is we'll take the $38,000 plus $114,000 plus $78,000 plus $285,000 minus the ending work in process inventory, and we'll get $502,000. So solving for our unknown, we find that ending work in process inventory is $13,000. What is the amount of cost of goods sold on the income statement? Well, when they ask for cost of goods sold for the income statement, we know that they mean cost of goods sold after adjustment. So let's make that calculation. Cost of goods sold schedule is beginning finished goods inventory. We will add the current cost added to finished goods, which is the cost of goods manufactured. This will give us cost of goods available for sale, minus the ending finished goods inventory, and we get cost of goods sold before adjustment. We will need to adjust for the under or over applied overhead cost to get cost of goods sold after adjustment. Now, we previously calculated in our cost of goods manufactured schedule, and it was given to be $502,000. The beginning and ending finished goods inventories are given, $80,000 at the beginning of the year. That means that we have cost of goods available for sale of $582,000. We subtract the $73,000 of ending finished goods inventory, and cost of goods sold before adjustment is $509,000. To finish the problem, we will need to find out if we have under or over applied overhead. To do this, the best thing to do is to set up the T account for manufacturing overhead. Now, looking at the information provided, we can see that we're given both the actual overhead cost and the applied overhead cost in the original information. Actual overhead cost incurred, $296,000. Manufacturing overhead cost applied to production, $285,000. This leaves us an $11,000 debit balance in the manufacturing overhead account. And this means that overhead was underapplied. We underassigned cost to inventory. We assigned $285,000 of cost to inventory, but we actually incurred $296,000. Therefore, when we go back to our schedule, since we under-costed our inventory, we're going to need to add the under-applied overhead. This will give us our cost of goods sold of $520,000, and this is the amount that will go on the income statement for cost of goods sold. That's it for this problem. This is one where we had to work backward to solve for an unknown, but you can see even in those cases, you just use the schedules and you can get your answer. Get some practice and ask questions if you have them.